I think that's the theme of today's video, a blend of anxiety and excitement. Where I am during the video, we'll soon find out. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? How you doing? I'm doing great. I'm ready to wear test, and I know you guys are too. The star product of today is a new release. This is the KVD Beauty Good Apple Foundation Balm. Number one, I love cream balms. Number two, you guys are super, super excited about it. And number three, I have no clue how I'm gonna address this brand because previously, when I reviewed this many, many years ago, and I mean many years. My last video on this brand was a contour review video of their shade and light palette 6 years ago. And foundation-wise, I reviewed their powder foundation and their traditional locket foundation 7 to 8 years ago, which is crazy. And I haven't really revisited the brand since. There was a lot of different things, but they have rebranded since. So now they are KVD Vegan Beauty. I will probably slip up and say Kat Von D a bunch of times because I mean that's just KVD for me. I'm not sure if the appropriate way to address it is just KVD because I know there's some difference when they flipped the brand, they rebranded and like re-ownership, and I don't know. I'm not here for the politics. I'm here for the product, you know. So we're gonna get into this new foundation balm that has 40 different shades. They'll be on the screen right now. I have shade medium 042. That was my guesstimation. I went off the online swatches, also referenced what I've reviewed in the past, and kind of cross-referenced the swatches. Do I think I nailed it? To be determined. I don't know. Let's see how good I really am. So my shade is kind of near that midpoint per usual, but I am a little lighter now. So if I was tan, I think I'd be like right in the middle of the 40 shades. I'm not. I'm spring me. You know, barely colored now. Shade 42 is a medium with warm undertones. The packaging is super cute, but just first impressions. I love the clean, I love the aesthetic, I love like, it's like a lightweight, you know, situation, but it's a lightweight situation. So I'm kind of worried that if this crack in travel, in your makeup bag, on your way to work, girl, you might have a situation on your hand because it's basically acrylic on the outside. And acrylic does crack. There's a little bit of a scratch on mine at the top. I ordered this from Sephora. It retails for $38 and it's a full coverage foundation. They have some hefty claims on her. But yes, I do like the little raised lip, you know, as far as like a very clean look and something different. But I'm kind of worried, like that doesn't give you a lot of wiggle room to like, if you crack an edge, you're gonna have a mess on your hands. Is that just me? It gives me a little bit of anxiety. All right, so my hair is like one day slept on waves with my waver. I'm gonna tie it back just for the time being because I just wanna get it out of the face. Do we need a headband? Yeah, all right, my black headband's a little loose today, but we got our hair back. I was gonna pull it back. I don't think I want to. I was looking a little egg-heady. My kiddos are actually behind me right now when I'm filming it, like on the other side of this wall. Also, if you hear them at any point, I apologize, that is mom life, but here we go. We're gonna get right in to applying since I only have one shade for you guys. And while we're blending, I'm gonna give you guys some of the claims. This is oddly satisfying. The brand claims that you can pile it on and it won't get cakey. It's a hyper creamy, full coverage, lightweight, long wear formula that won't clog your pores, and it comes in a fully recyclable packaging. Though it says full coverage, it does say buildable as well, and though it says matte, it also says hydrating, and it generally just has this long wear. So I just finished one side of my face to give you guys a little side by side. There you go. There you go. What do you think? A little real close up shot on that porridge. Nothing too crazy going on. I'm really excited to see how my skin looks after a chemical peel. I know like texture wise, I'm not doing too bad, but I mean scarage wise, where we gonna be at? You know, like I'm excited, so stay tuned for that. So first impressions from the application. The shade seems to work, like we can totally wear this. I dragged it down my neck because my neck be so pale. But otherwise, I mean like currently not a bad shade. We'll see a long shot in a second. But this is interesting. I don't know. I have an impression for cream balms that like I expected to go on like a better version of a cream foundation stick. You know what I mean? How those have to like kind of heat up with your skin. I feel like these, like I want it to like press into the skin and just like emulsify in a good way, like become my skin, make my skin look great. And I'm not saying the finish is bad, the finish is fine right now, it's not super matte. It's definitely that weird combination of like, they want this to be more of a matter cream, so it does set fast. It's not the easiest thing to like just move around. It's not the most enjoyable cream I've ever used. I'm not saying that's a non-starter for this, it's just a texture that I wasn't expecting. Like, you need to pat compared to like a rolling motion, you know what I mean. Hopefully. So in certain areas that my skin is naturally a little drier, like my nose, my chin, I feel like it's not as dewy, like it's set right away, or not as hydrating I should say. But the areas that are a little bit more normal, like, you know, they usually glow more even with just like moisturizer, like those look like they're hydrated, you know, they have a little bit more of like a oomph, a highlight, a spotlight to it. So let's catch up on the other side. And for those who are asking, because sometimes I forget to tell you guys what sponge I'm using, this is a sponge from Koki Cosmetics, K-O-K-I-E, and I have a couple of them. So if you see a purple beauty blender style one, it's usually the Koki one. If you see one that has more of like an 8 curvature, like a bottle shape, Coke bottle shape, that one is e.l.f.'s. So I'm gonna continue to pat this in. I personally don't like using a brush with balms because they pack too much product on. They do get it on faster and they blend out fast, but I don't wanna look cakey with this formulation, and it already is a pretty full coverage, as you can see, formulation. So it's definitely, you know, on brand for them from the products I've tried in the past. I remember when the tattoo concealer came out and I was like, girl, I don't got no tattoos, but I need this concealer. And you know, high school, college me was all about it. All about it. And now here we are. But I was also a huge fan, I've mentioned it before, of a Maybelline balm that was very similar to this, but it was creamier. It was their Dream Smooth. It got discontinued because, like Drake said, the good ones go, unfortunately, in the beauty community. I don't know why, but a few of you guys last time I mentioned it were like, oh my god, yeah. And I was like, yeah, that was like the best. And if this can give me a little what that gave me, I'm gonna be the happiest gal at the end of the day. So it's a heftier price tag for sure. But what options do I have? Not many. As you can see, it's actually quite quick. That's what I love about balms. A nice little sponge moment. So forgiving. The shade looks great. I'm very happy with the description of it. Just for a little long shot with my body. I think this could have been described as a light medium with warm, but I mean, a medium doesn't bother me either. It depends on what line you're talking about. But pretty good, pretty good. Impressed. So before I reviewed shade 054, so 54, in my past videos, but I don't know what I actually looked like 8 years ago. Like, I don't know if I was this complexion just wearing a darker foundation or what, but it looked quite dark on the model. So this is 54's model and this is 42's model, and those are my thoughts, you know, that's why I went with 42. If this finish can hold up exactly like this, I will love it at the end of the day. Will that happen? We never know. Because it's actually like way more satin, you know, kind of like half matte on the cheekbone down the forehead as well. But I like how it's sitting in this kind of like higher area. Like when the light wants to hit it, if I can angle my face enough, it looks pretty good. It does not look cakey. I will give them that. Will it be long wear? I'm gonna put a little bit of contour with Milk Makeup's Baked Stick. It's something I'm trying out. I warmed it up on the back of my hand. I'm actually gonna take this concealer brush and lightly bring it up using a really light amount and a really light hand. I want to do all this before any sort of super matte formula or powder hits our face. I don't want to use too much of that either, just because I don't want to make this any cakier than it needs to be. We will use a loose powder to set our oily areas, but we're just adding just a little bit of something. So let me finish up the other side. Alright, so now we need to conceal. I'm using the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet in 2.6 today, just on my high points of my face. I have reviewed this concealer separately. I reviewed it last summer, and it's like in a wear test that has a skin tint that's available at Sephora too. I think the brand's Ilia. So it doesn't have its own video for anyone who's having trouble finding it, but it's in a wear test and it's in the thumbnail. So if you just look it up, it should come up, and I'll try to remember to link it all for you guys down below. Whew, one of the best. And I'm not a matte concealer gal, but since we have a quote unquote matte foundation going on. I'm using my quote unquote matte but not matte concealer, you know, just one that's doing its own thing and it's meeting the contour on the side of my face. All the formulas are playing so well right now. Everyone's getting along. It's a good class we got today. All right, I think we're looking pretty good. So let's talk powder together. Let's talk a little bit about it. As much as I love this finish, it's not gonna work for us. It's really not gonna work for us. I'm gonna use a little bit of loose powder. This is from Orsay. This is their Come Closer powder, one of my Best of Beauty winners from last year. And I do have a coupon code for them now, which is great. It's like 20% off. So check that out down below. This brand's also Asian owned. So if you wanna support a brand that is also supporting the AAPI, I think I got the acronym right, community with everything going on right now, feel free to do so. I posted about them on my story. I think yesterday they did like 100% donations, but they are, like I said, an Asian owned brand. So representing. If you're looking for any of my coupon codes, I do have a page on my blog, which is samrobinson.blog/codes. It's always linked off down below. You can easily go there to see any of my active coupon codes. I don't usually put the ones there that I do have an expiration date for. So the ones I have on the site typically should work. Sometimes they expire on me without knowing. And then you guys like reach out to me and I try to fix it for you. But if you're ever looking for any of my codes, I have them listed there under, you know, a brand and a picture. And you can click the picture to go straight to the website. And typically most of them auto apply, but some don't. For example, my phone case is from Caseify, and if you use the link, it auto applies. And sometimes when you try to enter the code at checkout, it doesn't work. So using the link for that site specifically is always better. So I'm basically setting all the points we just concealed with just a little bit of powder, and then I'm gonna use it around my eyebrows and my T-zone. That's it. Sometimes I take out an eyebrow, and if I take out an eyebrow, it's always this eyebrow. So I'm gonna touch those up in a second. So our nose and our T-zone really has no excuse for like disappearing on us later. If it does, let's hope it doesn't. All right, I think we're looking pretty good. I wanna do a little highlight because I feel like we need a little bit of dimension. All right, so she threw on a quick little eye. I did a little Makeup by Mario moment. If you guys have been watching my recent videos, you know. So cheeks, I did a little Jouer blush in the shade Adore Me. This is her right there. As you can see, I didn't add any powder bronzer, but I did add a little bit of highlight. This is the highlight from the Film Star Bronze Glow Face Sculpt and Highlight from Miss Charlotte Tilbury. So that's on the high points of the cheekbones, down the bridge of thy nose, and the chin, Cupid's bow. Dark lip, medium tone lip. Okay, we're gonna go with Safe Bet Cafe from LA Girl. She's still cute, but she's not as dark as the other option, which was by Morphe. So I thought we could use my little custom lipstick. This is from Bite Beauty. I made it with their Lip Lab option, and I have a whole blog post about like what the mixture is if you guys wanna make it. I called it self-made, and you got a little Virgo moment, and it has like a minty finish. Ooh, she looked hydrated, we like that. So I think that's kind of it for us. I feel like, you know, like the eyes are like whatever today. We're just doing a, you know, just a moment. Just a subtle moment. I don't want to do anything too high tea. I'm not feeling high tea today. So I think that's it for us as far as our starting point goes. I'm gonna give you guys starting point pictures, close-up cam footage, and I'm gonna see you guys at the end of that day to see how Miss Good Apple Balm wore. It's 8:31 in the evening, and I am ready to talk about this foundation. So we've been wearing it for a little over 10 hours, and I didn't foresee what was about to happen today. So I originally like adored it during application. I'm a little more on the fence right now, and I will show you guys why. Let's put the pictures on the screen as well as the close-up cam footage. So the center of my nose is completely bare. All of the nostril and the nose tip, all of that is gone. I will say there was a moment where I felt like a mask situation where I, you know, I kind of like this with my nose after I took off my mask, and that probably didn't help, but it's definitely not transfer proof. Not that it said it was, but this is like, this foundation transfers. Like, you know, if you're eating food, like it wears around your mouth real easy, you know, like when your tissue like dabs any sort of contact, it's kind of coming off. Powder, no powder. But on the powder note, I don't like the areas that I applied powder on with this foundation. And I'm talking about like the powder around the brows. The area around my brows is actually super cakey, which I really don't like. Especially like a little bit of highlighter area around the brow, because I usually brush just a little bit like right here and right here. It started causing that like spiderweb cakey textured look. Ignore the fact that my under eyes look horrendous right now. The pencil liner I wore on my waterline transferred so much that I ended up having to just like use a Q-tip and take it off because it kept like stamping itself under here. That's its own issue. But the eyes were not part of this review, so we're not gonna worry too much about her. It says it was a hyper creamy, you know, creamy matte. So the areas that did not have powder also wore down a little bit as well. Like, I don't feel like any area that didn't have powder looks the same coverage wise. Like, I can still see my cheek products. Of course, it's faded a little bit, but the cheek product was the powder, you know what I mean? But anywhere that had powder got a little heavy and cakey looking. Like, it doesn't really like my highlight, my cheek. It didn't have a problem with the cream bronzer. The cream bronzer still seems to, you know, be where it needs to, minus the fact that this is all skin. And the rest of my face looks kind of dry. Like, I don't like that. So I don't like it with powder because it looks cakey, but then without it, it doesn't last. Does that make sense? Like, it doesn't last as well. Like, it's not totally gone, but it definitely is fading as far as not clogging pores. I mean, I didn't have any reaction immediately, but I can't say for the long term, of course. Does it feel lightweight as it claims? I would say sure. It's a little lightweight as long as you don't put powder. When you put the powder on, it then starts to feel a little stiff. But it specifically says pile it on, it won't get cakey. But it didn't particularly tell us that we could use powder or not use powder. So if you're gonna use it, my recommendation is to use it without powder. At least you get the pretty finish. At least you get that, ooh yeah, love that coverage effect. With it, you look a little heavy. My nose area didn't like it because it got set with powder and it instantly caked up on me. And I've used this powder quite a bit, never had issues with it. For me, I mean, it might not be the powder for everyone, but it's a loose, thin powder, and I wouldn't use one that I'm unfamiliar with while testing a foundation like this. So is it full coverage? Absolutely. Is it creamy on application? Yes. Do I think it looked hydrated without any powder? Yes. Do I think oily skin gals can wear this without powder? No, if you want it to last. You cannot come in contact with any mask or anything. Don't touch it with your hands. It's not gonna be there. It's not gonna be a good look from the get-go. I love the shade range. The shade range, amazing. Price is actually pretty reasonable as well. I just wish it performed differently because I don't know how I'm gonna wear it without powder if it won't last. I guess you could soak yourself with setting spray and just hope for the best, but I don't think it's gonna work out. So my neck, I did drag it down my neck to here, and for the most part, it's still there. I can see, like, you know, where my neck folds a little faded, but the problem is from the get-go, it looked really dry on my neck compared to my face, which I didn't like. I feel like there may be a chance that, like, depending on where you apply it or how your skin is, it might not look as hydrated from the get-go. Because my face, like, I take a lot of care with it, you know, a lot of collagen serums, a lot of glow serums before filming, a lot of blah 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 blah, the same stuff I would usually use. I prep it really well, and I prep it a little better than my neck. Like, my neck doesn't always get all the love, but it looked kind of more matte on that area. So I just wanted to disclaim that as well, since I observed that and I was like, So what will we grade her? I don't know. I really don't. It's definitely not an A. It's not an A product. Are you a B or are you a C? Shade range is good. Foundation good. No, no, no. I feel like I've been giving this grade out a lot, but I'm gonna give the KVD Vegan Beauty Good Apple Foundation Balm a B minus. I almost gave it a B, but I'm gonna go B minus. I feel like I look like a train wreck right now, and I don't want to look like that when I wear the foundation. And I don't want to say, like, oh, for the price tag, only wear it for a few hours, so, you know, great for it. Like, I don't think that's what a full coverage foundation balm should be. I wouldn't say it gives you the same thing as a tinted moisturizer. If it's a tinted moisturizer, maybe it'd be a little different, but a B minus it shall be. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing my first impressions. A lot of you were waiting for it. I'm sorry if it wasn't what you expected. I wish I was as in love with it as I was earlier. as I was 10 hours later, but that's why we do these wear tests. So if you guys enjoyed, please leave a thumbs up. I appreciate it. It really does help the channel. I'll leave my recent uploads on the screen right now, as well as the subscribe button if you have not subscribed yet and you would like to join our fam. Stick around, watch my content a little bit. You can hit that. She's free 99. We appreciate you. And that is it for me today. I can't wait to get this off my face. And I hate having to say that. I mean, granted, like, long day, who doesn't want to take off their makeup? But I was already annoyed, especially how uncomfortable it got in the powdered areas. Like, I can see it stretching when I'm making faces, and it just looks not great. Like, it looks heavy, and I don't, it's not my thing. So that's it. I'm done. Take care. I'll see you guys in a later video.